It's 8:28 right now. This video is supposed to come out way earlier today. I just got home from work. Sorry, busy day, busy schedule. I get home from work about 30 minutes ago. My parents are like, hey, you need to go pick up your sister from show choir practice. And I was like, no, because I got to get this out. Because I care about you guys. You guys are priority. And they said, you need to go now. I was like, well, what are y'all doing? And then they kind of like ignored me and walked away. And so, but I knew that I would get grounded if I didn't do it. So, yeah. So if this video don't come out on time, it's their fault, and I'm not going to be punished.
Also, I got y'all got a high school review on Sunday. Let's get it.
Hey, my name is King, and today we're taking a look at Rent-A-Girlfriend. Now, listen. I've never been too bad with girls. You know, the girls that I'm interested in. I'm a very, very picky guy. I don't know why. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not like a chick magnet. It's not like girls, like, fall over for me and, like, will go to any ends to be... No. But I've had my fair share of girls be interested in me. I've had my fair share of girls not be interested in me, mainly because of this right here. But, you know, if I actually wanted a girlfriend, I never had that much trouble getting one. But even as someone who didn't have that much trouble with girlfriends, it still would be nice to rent a girlfriend. Boom! There you go. Joke of the year right there. I know I had a huge build up, guys.
Fantastic.
All right, so I'm gonna be real with you guys. I'm gonna be so real with y'all. So real. There was a point in this series. Story time. If y'all wanna skip straight to the review, you can skip to this point right here, but it's a really interesting story, okay? Let me get the mug. Story time. Gotta get the glasses, hang on. Put them right there, there you go. Story time with King. So I was actually gonna watch The Two Towers yesterday because The Two Towers review was originally scheduled to come out today. But I was like, you know what? I'll watch the first half of the first season of Rent-A-Girlfriend, and then I'll watch The Two Towers, and then I'll finish Rent-A-Girlfriend tomorrow so I can review it the next day. Because Rent-A-Girlfriend review, this video was supposed to come out tomorrow, and the video that's coming out tomorrow was supposed to come out today. Okay? But then I started watching it, and I couldn't stop myself. I just kept hitting next. And before I knew it, it was 3 a.m. and I had binged all of Rent-A-Girlfriend in one sitting. Have I reached weeb level yet? I've never been that far. Only Sword Art Online. I've only been a weeb for Sword Art Online. Speaking of Sword Art Online, where's my Yu-Gi-Oh? Yu-Gi-Oh! Got it. Other story time. Second story time. There is second story time. If you are not the person who enjoys sexual-based humor on a consistent level and a very in-depth level, this one might not be for you. There is a 90-second scene in this anime, and if you've seen the anime or read the manga, you know what the freak I'm talking about. Like, my dude instincts went off, and I was like, I put my headphones off, tossed them on the thing, and I literally walked out of my room, and I said, nope. And my brother's over here, he's like, what's going on? And I was like, bro, I'm not gonna say it because, you know, family appropriate and also spoilers, but I literally sat here for like 5 minutes just having a mental like debate with myself whether I should watch this. I was like, guys, it's for the channel, and the other part was me like, dude, you're gonna ruin your masculinity watching this, and the other part was like, you don't have any masculinity, and this part was like, shut up, and this part was like, dude, if you don't do this video, you're gonna have to think of another video to come out. And then I did it because I'm too lazy. So without further ado, Rent-A-Girlfriend. Kinoshita Kazuya is a 20-year-old failure of a college student. He managed to kiss his girlfriend once, but got dumped after a month. Ugh, dang it, I never want to go through that again. Completely spiteful, Kazuya uses a certain method to date a girl. He goes to their meeting place and suddenly hears, "You're Kazuya-kun, right?" A beautiful girl, brushing her long black hair behind her ear, was there, smiling at him. Her name was Mitsuhara Chizuru. Something real is born after just a single rental. A reckless rom-com filmed with love and excitement is about to begin. I don't know if excitement's the word. I would say strong just cringe. Like, it felt like my face was gonna be like, for the rest of my life. Like, that was the face like I watched this show. Alright, so let's examine this poster real quick. Now, it might be all innocent and all cutesy. Oh, look at these four little cute girls. Nah. See, so we actually have best girl Mitsuhara right there in the smack dab center with the brown hair. They say black in her description and in the bio of the show. It's clearly brown slash red. I think the people who made this were colorblind. And to her left, we have the scum of the earth! Mami-chan. Now, Mami-chan is Kazuya's ex-girlfriend, and she is probably the closest thing to a villain in this show. That's not a spoiler. That's like a basic fact that shows up within like the first few episodes of the show and then is consistent throughout. That's not a spoiler. And the lengths she goes to, at first it's like, okay, she's a bit annoying. Maybe she's doing some weird things here and there. But then by like episode 4, you're like... composure. But what I really want to talk about on this poster are the two girls on the outside. Because not only are they on the poster, but they're in the opening. And the girl on the left, Ruka-chan, is a main character through this entire arc. But the problem is, she's underage. And they keep sexualizing her. I'm pretty sure she's in high school. I think she's like 15 or 16 in this show. But we see her panties multiple times. Destin, hey, is that child pornography?
What?
If they have an underage anime girl being sexualized and we like see your panties a few times, is that child pornography? Is that child hentai?
How old is she?
She's like 15 or 16.
In Japan, no, because the age of consent is 14. It is overseas, but...
Man, that ruined my whole argument! Ooh, look that up. What is the age of consent? Kanest in Japan. Boop. 13!
Remember, Japan is really, like, open with, like, sexual stuff, but they're, like, against a lot of gore and whatnot. And, like, we're the opposite. We're all for gore, but really against, like, sexual stuff.
13? 13! Ah! Man, this is gonna be a good video.
Hey,
thanks.
Give me the review so I can talk
this. Hey, now. Thanks for that. This is gonna be fun. I'm leaving that in. Like, it's not gonna show you, but it's just gonna, like, show my reaction with some funny music on, some funny zooms. Anyways, but this girl on the right, I think her name is, like, Sumi or something. And everybody in the comments of the, let me just go to a random episode. Let's go to 18, because she's in the thumbnail for this episode. Truth and Girlfriend. And you'll see clearly as the top comment by Scrollar, all of my homies love Sumi-chan. Sumi-chan is the best girl for me. Loving Sumi-chan is a lifestyle. All my Sumis love homie-chan. Mommy can F off. There you go. Sumi-chan is love. Sumi-chan is like, that's okay. Anyways, but if you read this, it just scrolls for this entire page stuff about Sumi. She shows up for one episode, but they treat her as if she's like this huge main character. She's on the poster, she's in the opening, and then I'm like, who the freak is this girl? Maybe she'll be introduced like, you know, halfway through or something. No, she shows up for one episode and then never shows up again. Once again, this is based on a manga, so maybe she has like a bigger role as the manga continues, but if you're gonna have a season covering this amount of time and she's not a big role for that, why are you making such a big deal about this, you know? And also, she doesn't like say anything or anything. She's like, I don't know, it's kind of pointless. I don't know why she was here. I feel, anyway, I don't know where I'm going with this review. Overall, this anime is a comedy, and what is the number one goal of a comedy? It has to make me laugh. And this anime made me laugh multiple times, but it made me cringe multiple times. I think, I don't know which one it did more, so I don't know if I had a positive or negative experience with the show. Either way, I say go check it out. Personally, I got hooked. I don't know if I liked it or not, but I got hooked and I just had to know how the show ended. And also the show ending. Ah! I thought, and I get you want to set up for a sequel or for another season, but I thought that they were going to like do, I thought they were going to do like a Chernibyo type thing or a Clannad type thing. That's all I'm going to say about that without spoilers. If you know what those are, you know what I'm talking about. If you don't, sorry. But no, they completely voice crack. They completely like, they make this choice building up to it. You get to the final episode, you make this choice, the credits roll, and then at the end, they back right out of it. They're like, you know what? Actually, let's not do this. Let's resort our main character back to the piece of trash that he is, and then we'll figure it out in the next season where we'll pretend to give him a character arc again and then do the same thing over and 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 over till we get a profit. Overall, my biggest flaws with this anime, don't sexualize underage children, but you know, that's just America. That's just my morals. But hey, once again, the age of consent is 13, so I don't know. Have characters that serve a point to the story and have them be like on, you know, have them be in your marketing. Don't market someone, because I was so interested. I was like, ooh, all these girls look so confident except for this girl on the right, Sumi-chan. Who is she? And then she shows up for one episode and never again. And I'm like, whoa, I have no reason to care about this girl. And then don't have the 90-second scene that you had in this where I literally like almost had like a panic attack. Well, anyways, guys, I will say that Rent-A-Girlfriend was a lot like eating McDonald's. Yeah, it was, they kind of, you know what I mean? But in terms of quality, I would say that this was a 6 out of 10. Well, anyways, guys, if you guys think if you guys are more interested to go check out Rent a Girlfriend, you can go do that. It's on Crunchyroll right now. The show just finished, so you should be able to watch all the episodes. Makes a good binge, I think. And if you've already seen the show, leave your thoughts in the comments down below. What did you think about Rent a Girlfriend? I'd love to hear that down below. Well, anyways, guys, I hope that you guys liked this video. If you did, you already know what to do. Starburst stream! That like button. Subscribe today to join the Royals. And hit the notification bell so you get more awesome videos just like this one. That's it for me today, guys. Roll out.